answering some of the questions that we got from a video that we've created on how to access Image Creator and how to prompt these amazing images so that you have beautiful images that you could use for your videos or for your designs on social media or your projects or wherever you want to use them. So we are going to start with a prompt of creating something that you wouldn't ordinarily get. And I think that's the whole point in my mind of AI. We are seeing a lot of images and I'm getting bored with the images that I'm seeing over and over of a similar person and a type and a pixel. It's getting boring. So we need to start being very creative with our creations. It is one of the art that we're going to evolve with, and we're going to start creating beautiful arts. And I'll add the prompt in the description below so that you also go and you try it yourself. And this is our first try. And that's one of the questions that I got and we're answering is, how many times can you try to get the image that you want? As many times as you can to get the exact image that I want. This is very close to what I want, but I would love for her to be outside and the waiter on inside the phone and pouring it outside. So I'm going to try again, change the prompt a little bit so that we have the waiter coming from the phone screen. I would have loved this particular image to this one. Oh, love it. I would have loved this particular image to be vice versa, but I'll take it. What you would then do is you would download this or you would customize it. So the next question was the aspect ratio, the sizing. How do we do that if we've used Image Creator and we want to work with Image Creator? So you have this option of opening up Bing Editor by creating customize, is open up. It looks very similar to online editors like Canva and Adobe Express. So you would have selected the image that you would like to change the sizing, and you're gonna go on the drop down arrow and pick the resize. When you select resize, it gives you different options that you can size your design or your image. So you can pick whichever one that you want. It will, if you click on show all and you scroll down, it gives you all different sizes that you could choose from. There's most popular, and then there's the current size that we're currently on. You could also customize by clicking create a custom size and then picking your own size. I, for example, would like to use this for this video's thumbnail, therefore I would change the size into 1280 by 720 the height, and then I click on continue and it changes the sizing and then it resizes it. So you could resize it in a new tab or you could resize to replace. So I'm just going to replace it and then adjust it as I go along. So that's the one thing I wanted to show you. But it has, when you've selected the image, it does have the options that you're used to, like change the background, replace, crop, and you could go along and make sure that you choose whatever you want. And it also has the, when you click and you tick the options that are available, for example, templates, your media, visuals, text, as well as a brand kit that's available on this editor as well. There's also AI tools that are available that you could use, like removing background or removing somebody from the image. So they do have tools like that. But I was answering the question, how do we resize? You saw how we resize. How do I give credit to the AI that has generated the image for me? So it is based on where you are and where you're generating the image from. Currently at the moment, we are using Microsoft Bing Image Creator, and this is from Designer. So if you want to give credit to the AI, you would say it's a Microsoft Image Creator. That's the AI that would have generated the image for you. If you're on Canva and you're using Canva's AI, you would give Magic Studio the credit because it would have been a Canva AI. If you're using Leonardo, if you're using Playground, whichever AI tool that you're using to generate the image, if you want to give credit on description, then write the name of the tool that you have generated the image from. One of the other questions we got is, how can you create an image that is not cutting off limbs and heads and things like that? I found in my experience that it depends on which tool you're using. I have not had a problem with Image Creator, the Bing. I've had a little bit of problems with Mid Journey at the beginning and the Canva tool. But I think as we all using this AI and we are instructing the AI, it's learning the way that it should be creating these images for us. So to answer your question, how can you make sure that the limbs and hands and things are correct? It depends on the tool that you're using. So with Canva, I actually tell the software, the hands should be proper and it should not look weird. And so as you can see, I've asked this one to create a basketball player. Everything looks proper, hands everywhere. It's perfect, I'm happy. So the designers and the developers of these tools also want us to continue using them. They will want to make sure that we continue using them if they continue giving us good product. So carry on and trying using different ones and have fun with it. The other question I wanted to answer was, somebody's saying to me that they're creating images and they're getting armpit hair. I am not seeing armpit hair anywhere on this image. So for me, it might boil down to, which tool are you using? With the image creator, we can clearly see no armpit hair. And he hated that and he said to me it was gross, and we said we're gonna try it together and see what happened. I am not getting armpit hair. Let's try an African basketball player and see how the hands and the armpit comes out as. Let's see how that turns out. Ooh, that looks so good. I don't see hair anyway. I really don't. That looks really, really good. And if you wanna learn more about Canva, I do have a Canva course on Udemy. So if you wanna support the channel and you wanna support me, it is on special right now. Please go to Udemy and buy the course. The link is in the description. Thank you so much for joining me on this video. I will see you on our next video.